Alrighty, welcome to a flashback draft. This is Aether Revolt Kaladesh. So if you didn't play these formats, it's a wild one. A lot of weird artifacts, a lot of cool stuff going on, and I'll do my best to walk you through this, though. Honestly, I haven't drafted this set in a while either. Still great at it, of course. One of the best of all time. Also, I'm going to take the rare. Quicksmith Spy is 3 and a blue for a 2/3, and when it enters the battlefield, target artifact you control gains tap, draw a card for as long as you control Quicksmith Spy. So by taking the Spy, you basically make one of your artifacts into a looter. Or not a looter, a tome. It just straight draws a card. There's also 7 mana, 7 fives, improvise. You can pay for it with artifacts. Shonda's Revolution is a deal for. Renegade Rally or whatever. There's some stuff, but nothing as good as Quicksmith Spy. So what do we got here? Secret Salvage. This card's probably bad, right? Yes, exile a non-land card from your graveyard and search your library for a bunch of copies of it. No good. Siege Modification gives a creature or vehicle +3/+0 on first strike enchantment. I don't want that either. Tezzeret's Touch. Remember, energy is one of the themes of this set. You make energy. So Tezzeret's Touch is a blue-black card that makes an artifact into a 5/5, and then when it dies, you get it back to your hand. That's not bad. I do like Aether Poisoner. It's 2 mana for a 1/1 Death Touch, gives you 2 energy when it enters the battlefield, and then when you attack, you can use that 2 energy to make a 1/1 artifact. So that's probably what I'm interested in, unless there's something really good here. No, Destructive Tampering. Druid of the Cowl, the 1/3 that taps for a green is fine, but Quicksmith Spy makes me want artifacts, so taking a blue-black artifact card is better. I think the Poisoner is a little better than Tezzeret's Touch. Nothing else here is super enticing. Oh, Fatal Push. Yeah, I'm going to take that. That's just a great card. The Foundry Hornet is a 4 mana, 2/3 flying, and then when it enters the battlefield, if you have a +1/+1 counter on one of your creatures, your opponent's creatures get -1/-1. That's like the green-black theme is +1/+1 counters, but easy Fatal Push. Just a really good, efficient card. There's a reason this is like a multi-format all-star here. Okay, here, ooh, Cogwork Assembler. I kind of like this card. 3 mana, 2/3, and you can pay 7 to copy an artifact, but probably not going to take it. Servo Schematic, on the other hand, 2 mana, and it makes a 1/1 servo when it enters the battlefield, but also when it leaves the battlefield. Okay, I don't think Implement of Examination is great. It's just a slow card draw thing. Return a creature from a graveyard to your hand. If you control an artifact, draw a card. That's not too bad. I think the Schematic is just good enabling. You also want to put like Quicksmith Spy on it. I'm not 100% sure, but it feels like you can get a resourceful return a little bit later. So I think that that's going to be fine here. Here we've got Defiant Salvager. Okay, so this kind of works nicely. It's 3 mana for a 2/2. You can sack an artifact or creature to put a +1/+1 counter on this. Only as a sorcery, which makes it a little worse. But sacking Servo Schematic to that is pretty good. There's the white Implement. Meh. There's 3 mana 2/2. Pay 2 and a blue scry one. Meh. Prey Upon is fine. Gremlin Infestation. You put this on an artifact and it deals 2 to the controller every turn. And then when it dies, you get a 2/2. Yeah, let's just take Defiant Salvager. I think blue-black improvise slash artifact seems like a pretty good place to be in this set, if I remember correctly. And these cards have some nice synergy. This Servo Schematic is really kind of tying the room together. It's good with both Defiant Salvager and Quicksmith Spy. Also, Defiant Salvager is good with Revolt. Sack this, sack something to give it a +1/+1 counter, then Fatal Push their 4-drop. Sounds pretty reasonable to me. Okay, here, Daredevil Dragster, 3 mana, 4/4, crew 2. And then whenever it attacks or blocks at the end of combat, it gets a velocity counter. Then if it has 2 or more of those counters, sack it and draw 2. Okay. There's also Ornithopter. the red Implement. I'm kind of interested in this Daredevil Dragster. I mean, it might be okay. I don't think Welder Automaton is very good. Reckless Racer is actually fine, but let's take the Dragster. If I have a couple things to crew it should be all right. Oh man, look at this thing. 1 mana, 7/11, and you can pay 6 to crew, or it's crew 6. The Pima Aether Seer is a 4 mana, 3/2. You get energy equal to your greatest power, and then you can make creatures block, sure, whatever. Shipwreck Moray, it's a 0/5 for 4, you get 4 energy. And you can pay an energy to get +2/-2. That's not bad. This is 3 mana to give a permanent indestructible and make a 1-1 servo. I might just take the turret. 3 mana taps to get an energy or remove 3 energy to deal 2 damage to target creature or planeswalker. No, actually, I think I'll take the moray. That's a moray. 5 mana, 4-4, when it attacks, return an artifact you control to your hand. Okay, so it bounces your own artifacts, which can be good with like servo schematic. Yeah, that sounds okay. It's a 5 mana, 4-4. It's that or a 2-3 mana, 2-3 menace, or a 3 mana, 3-1 that can block two things. Let's take the Scuttler. Ooh, I guess I will take Barricade Breaker. So I need to pick up as many artifacts as possible. It's 7 mana, 7-5, but you could tap artifacts to help pay for it. All right, so I guess I kind of wish I took the artifact over Shipwreck Moray. Other than that, I kind of like where we're at. I guess I'm more likely to want Iron Tread Crusher, though. I could also just take Druid of the Cowl. It's the best card in this pack, and if green is that open that late, who knows? 3 mana, 3-4, Crew 2, whenever it attacks, untap an artifact or creature you control. 3 mana, 3-1 can block an additional creature, or 3 mana, 2-2 that you can scry one, or indestructible make a 1-1. Let's just take the 3 mana, 2-2, I guess. Okay, so Cogwork Assembler is back. 3 mana, 2-3, you can pay 7 to make a copy of an artifact. I think I like that a little more than Implement. We've just got a bunch of random artifacts. All right, I guess I'll take the Implement of Improvement. So when this is 1 mana, and you can sack it to gain 2, when it was put in the graveyard, draw a card, which means if I get more sack stuff, then I can just play off-color implements because I can just sack them to draw a card. And then I have improvised stuff. So I also have 2 expensive improvised cards. Let's get this Shipwreck Moray out. We're going to try to play as many artifacts as possible. I like our start, though. We've got 3 good black cards, 1 good blue card, and then Salvage Scuttler is just whatever. When it attacks, return an artifact you control. It doesn't do much except for with servo schematic. I can technically bounce Dragster if I don't want this to get up to 2 velocity, but you kind of just do. Aether Geode Miner, 2 mana, 3-1. When it attacks, you get 2 energy, and you can exile it. Yeah. All right, so what do we got? Hungry Flames. And that's a good card. Monstrous Onslaught, that's a good card, but not really for me. Perilous Predicament's not bad. Each opponent sacks an artifact creature and a non-artifact creature. You can often get 2 creatures with that. And then I'll maybe wheel some of these random dorky artifacts. Implement of Malice would be kind of nice. But I think I just take the Predicament. Call for Unity. A Revolt gets a counter, and creatures you control get +1/+1 for each counter. That is a good card, but I think I'm just going to take Aether Swooper. This card was great. 2 mana, 1-2 flyer. It gets 2 energy when it ETBs. When it attacks, you can pay 2 energy to make a 1-1 servo. It's exactly what this deck wants. And then there's some other dorky artifacts that I might wheel here. We're deep into blue-black artifacts, which is a deck I like to draft, to say the least. Yeah, we want as many cheap artifacts as we can get so we could improvise out some of these things. I don't know about this 5 mana 3-3 improvise. It seems a little weak, but we'll see, I suppose. Crack it open, a cold Spindrift. Kind of a room temperature Spindrift, to be honest, if we're being completely honest. In terms of removal, we have a Fatal Push and a Perilous Predicament. We also have a 1-1 Death Touch. So that's like a pretty reasonable amount of stuff. I don't have anything really good to bounce with the Salvage Scuttler yet. I would like to pick up 1 or 2 things more. And copying with Cogwork Assembler, I'm not sure. Ooh, Baral's Expertise. 5 mana, bounce up to 3 things, and you can play a 4 mana spell. Okay. That's good. So is Trophy Mage. 3 mana, 2-2. Search your library for a 3 casting cost artifact. I do have that. Is that better than Baral's Expertise? There's nothing else that really comes close, no. So, this is a great card advantage card. Obviously, I'd be very happy to play Trophy Mage. I kind of feel like the Expertise is going to be a good enough tempo play that it's worth taking here. Bouncing 3 things is pretty nice for 5 mana. And if I just go like 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop, expertise, bounce three things, then play another like three drop or something. Obviously, that's an ideal scenario, but I still think it's good to have some interaction. And this, if you've got a 3 or 4 mana spell to play, this doesn't really cost you very much mana. Okay. Well, here there's Metallic Rebuke, improvise counterspell unless they pay three. There's also 4 mana 2/2 that dies into a 1/1 flyer. There's also 5 mana 3/2 can bounce one of their artifacts. Or 3 mana gets energy. I think I'm just going to take the automaton. 1 mana 1/1, you can pay two to pump it. I just want a cheap artifact at this point. If you just take enough cheap artifacts, this deck comes together pretty nicely. Right now, I'm not playing this implement unless I get another way to sack. Because right now, I just have the one way to sacrifice. And that is not quite enough. Quicksmith Spy is very good. Let's just broaden its surveillance lens. What am I making copies of with Cogwork Assembler? I don't know. Oh, Foil Planar Bridge. 6 mana. You can pay 8, tap, search library for a permanent, put it into play. So what does this one do? 6 mana 4/4. When it enters the battlefield, you may sack an artifact. If you do, put two counters on this, and each opponent loses 2 life. Okay, I'm in for that. This could be a good 6-drop. I'll have artifacts to sacrifice. 6 mana 6/6. They lose 2 life is not a bad card. And between augmenting automaton, counters from these three things, just the fact that I'm gonna have Raid of Dwarks. Excuse me. Okay, so there's a Dispersal Technician, 5 mana 3/2. I kind of like Fourth Bridge Prowler, 1 mana 1/1, it enters the battlefield, you give a creature -1/-1 to end of turn. It's not an artifact, but this card's really efficient. I think better than Filigree Crawler. I don't really need to take a 4-drop when I could take a good 1-drop. Like, how many creatures in my deck does it kill? Kills this, kills Poisoner, kills the token off Schematic. Yeah, I mean, it already kills at least three things, not to mention the token off Swooper. I could also bounce it with Baral's Expertise if I wanted to. Not a terrible play. Plus, it's good with Perilous Predicament because it kills their 1/1s, which makes them then have to sack something else instead. We have 18 playables. We're deep into Pack 2. I like where we're at. Still a ways away from playing this Foundry Assembler. Oh man. Spider Patrol is good. 4 mana 3/2 flying when ETBs tap a creature for a turn. All right, so which implement do I want? The blue one that sacks to draw a card, so it really sacks to draw two, or the black one that sacks for them to discard a card. I think I'm going to take the black one because it's cheaper. I also don't want 5 mana 3/3 plus 3 energy. Let's just take the black implement. Just cheaper cards are good. Crackdown Construct. Whenever you activate an ability of an artifact or a creature that isn't a mana ability, this gets +1/+1 until end of turn. I don't think I have enough cards to make that work. Do I want Metallic Rebuke? Metallic Rebuke is okay. There's another Foundry Assembler, or I could take another Watchful Automaton. These are all pretty marginal. I think I'll take Metallic Rebuke. It's good interaction. It's a good reward for picking up 1-drops. I'm still just looking to take any cheap artifacts I find here. And if I get enough, I think the Salvage Scalder's probably out. 2 mana 0/3, you can pay 5 to return a creature to owner's hand. 3 mana, the energy turret. There's also return target creature from your graveyard to your hand. If you control an artifact, draw a card. I like that. I have some good creatures to get back. Quicksmith Spy, Aether Swooper, even just the Prowler is fine. I was wanting to pick up one of those. I guess I will take another Foundry Assembler. And then I'll take a Consulate Turret. I finally picked one of those up. I don't think I really want Negate all that much. So this is 22. I'm hoping to cut the Consulate Turret. I like these 5 spells. All right. These are all very similar. I guess I'll take Dispersal Technician. I don't think I really want to play that. I kind of want to cut. Oh, here, I'll pass someone out Planar Bridge. I kind of want to cut all the things that aren't artifacts. Well, I have 9. And the Poisoner and the Swooper both kind of count as artifacts, so yeah, that's probably fine. This Daredevil Dragster, Watchful Automaton, yeah, a lot of these can easily go. Basically, if I don't get like three more cheap artifacts, then the Foundry Assemblers are not going to be good. But if I get a bunch of one drop artifacts, like Augmented Automaton type cards, then I'll be pretty happy with them. Oh, Confiscation Coup? Oh, we're taking this. Five mana, choose an artifact or creature. You get four energy, and then you can pay energy equal to its mana value. And if you do, gain control of it. There's also Chief of the Foundry, Glint Nest Crane. Yeah, these were some good cards. I remember playing a lot of these in Constructed too. But Confiscation Coup is just a bomb. So this makes me want to cut Metallic Rebuke, maybe. I have 3 5 mana spells. That's a little chunky, but there's also Ironclad Revolutionary potentially as a cut. I'm basically trying to maximize my artifact count. I don't want to go low on artifacts. I would like to also replace some of these 3 mana artifacts with better ones if I can find them. Yeah, Confiscation Coup was a good one. That is for sure. Okay. So, first picked a coup. Wouldn't mind picking up some more cheap implements. I would still like one more sacrifice card. Just if I had three cards that let me sacrifice artifacts, I'd be pretty comfortable playing off-color implements. Ooh, Cultivator of Blades. I remember this card. This one's good. Aether Tradewind, no. Glassblower's Puzzle Knot versus Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot. Okay. So this gives me Scry 2, 2 energy, and then you can sack it to do it again. This is draw a card, lose a life. I think I just take the Metal Spinners because I don't really care about energy. Like, Confiscation Coup powers itself. The Swooper and the Poisoner power themselves. Like, yeah, I could use more energy, but Puzzle Knot, I think, is going to be a little bit better. And this is the exact kind of card I need for these, like, improvised things. It's good with Quicksmith's Spy. Ironclad Revolutionary, just all of it. I wonder if there's a world where I cut fourth Bridge Prowler. Probably not, but I suppose you never know. I don't have that many cheap artifacts. Not as many as I would like. I guess I have three over here, so I have five artifacts that cost two or less. Counting the two poisoners, seven. Yeah, it's all right. Ooh, the modules. So this is two mana. Whenever a creature you control enters the battlefield, you get an energy, and then four tap, return a creature you control to its owner's hand. Okay, I think I'd rather just take the Cogworker's Puzzle Knot or the Fireforger's Puzzle Knot. So do I want a 1-1 or do I want to deal one? I just want a 1-1, right? Because making two artifacts is, I think, better. I don't think I use energy enough to do this. Return a creature you control to its owner's hand is not that great. Let's just take Cogworker's Puzzle Knot. And that counts as like a two-drop creature, actually. This is 23. Let's see, there's another Puzzle Knot. Restoration Gearsmith was really good too. Bound, return a creature or artifact from a graveyard to your hand, but I think I'm just gonna. And Skywither Shot was also good. But I think I just take another Puzzle Knot. Just putting two artifacts into play is very much what I'm in the market for. And I probably cut Watchful Automaton at this point. I think the Daredevil Dragster is kind of interesting. I recall it being okay, not great. This is 23, but now we're actually doing well on cheap artifacts. So now we're gonna get to do some good stuff. What do we got? Concealed Courtyard. Had I taken the Restoration Gearsmith, maybe? 5 mana Menace, 8/6 Crew 4, no. 5 mana 4/4. When it enters the battlefield, you search your library for an assembly worker creature and put it in your hand. I don't have. Oh, I do have one assembly. Having one. Oh, these are also assembly workers. All right. Yeah, we'll self-assemble. It's not like I really need another five drop, but I think that's okay. Oh, I think Animation Module is the busted one. Whenever one or more counters are put in a permanent you control, you can pay one, and if you do, you make a servo. So I have counters are put on a permanent, so the energy doesn't count. I have Defiant Salvager. And I have Ironclad Revolutionary. That's it. And then you can pay three and tap and choose a counter on a permanent or player and give that permanent or player another type. So it can generate energy, but that's not that good. No. I think I just take Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot. And 7 mana, 5/7 Fabricate One. I do love this card. Wealdfast Wingsmith. 4 mana, 3/3, and it gets flying whenever artifact ETBs. Sure, I'm probably not going to play that, but I'll take it anyway. 5 mana, draw 3? I don't really need that. Let's just take another Cogworker's Puzzle Knot. Jangeat Sentry. 3 mana 2/3, you can tap or untap artifact or creature. No. 3 mana 1/2, when it dies, return an artifact from your graveyard to your hand. Oh, there's also Gear Seeker Serpent. Oh, I like this. This costs 1 less for each artifact you control. So it's kind of like Menace, or kind of like Improvise, but Affinity instead. I don't think I want the gain 3 energy card, but I don't think I'm going to play Aether Trade Winds either. Yeah, I'm a little more likely to want Aether Trade Winds, but return target, tap creature, draw a card, sure. All right, so this is 27. Let's cut the fourth Bridge Prowler. Honestly, let's cut Ironclad Revolutionary. This is 25. I'm just trying to cut basically all the things that aren't artifacts. Oh, I can probably cut Implement of Improvement. I don't really have a good way to sack artifacts. All these other puzzle knots and implements I can use the abilities of. I could play 16 land. I don't think I need to do that, though. Do I want to cut the Cogwork Assembler? I think with 1, 2, 3, effectively 4 improvised cards, playing all these puzzle knots is going to work out pretty nicely. Should I play Ironclad Revolutionary? That's actually an interesting question. I feel like giving Confiscation Coup, Baral's Expertise, Perilous Predicament, Gear Seeker, Self-Assembler, like, I have good high-end stuff. Do I cut Cogwork Assembler as the last card? I don't think I'm going to cut Daredevil Dragster. I could cut a Cogworker's Puzzle Knot, but I don't really like doing that either. Let's take a look here. Let's take a little look. I like all the Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knots. I mean, I guess with double Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot, let's see, how many things expensive cards actually cost mana? I guess, yeah, no, I have two. I can't play 16 lands. I gotta play 17. I guess it has to, I think, be Cogwork Assembler or Daredevil Dragster, and I think I cut the Cogwork Assembler to start with. 10-7. Sure, that seems quite reasonable. All right, let's see how this does. Alrighty, time for round one. I would like to play first, and all right, I will keep this hand. It's a little, you know, needs a little assistance, but I've turned 2 Servo Schematic into turn 3 Daredevil Dragster. So if I draw any creature by turn 4, I can crew the Dragster, start getting in, and then I have Raise Dead draw a card, which is pretty nice too. So as long as I don't just draw lands. Got 2 more draw steps to draw a creature, and I feel like I'm in pretty good shape if I do that. I also can improvise out anything big with this start. Ooh, okay, the puzzle knot's not bad, as it were, because now I can draw an extra card if I miss, and hopefully I have a lot of 2 drops, so hopefully I draw something cheap. Hinterland Drake. Can't block artifacts. All right. Swamp, all right. Oh, Foundry Assembler, perfect, because look, I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Crew with the Assembler. Oh, you love it when a plan comes together. And then just gets a velocity counter, which means next turn, if I can hit with this and it survives, I get to draw 2 cards. Okay, what'd they do? Oh, this gets 1 energy and then can give haste. All right. The beatdowns commence. A creature would be nice there. I think I'm still gonna crew with this. I'm losing 1 point of damage here. Maybe 2 if I were to draw. No, it would still just be 1 point because I'm crewing it for 3 instead of 2. That's a 3-3. Let's just attack. Draw 2 cards. I just don't want to tap a bunch of mana when I'm about to draw a couple cards here. Let's play the Swooper, get 2 energy, play a land, and then pass. I'm going to crack the Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot end of turn here. I'm taking another 5 down to 9, but I should be able to stem the bleeding at this point because I'm going to have this left to block in a turn or two. Another 2-3 flyer, can't block artifacts. And a ping for 1. Oh, kills my servo. All right. Land, okay. Oh, Confiscation Coup. That's a good one. Let's see. Why don't I just take the untapped Drake? Yes. And I have three energy left. Yeah, I'll attack and make a Serino. Pass the turn, and now my Drake can block their Drake. They're at six. I like where we're at. I can also chump the Spontaneous Artist with my Servo token, which honestly I might do. Unfortunately, I don't have a target for this Resourceful Return. None of my creatures have died. Okay, 4 mana, 2/2 draw card. Sure, that's not too scary. That means they're probably not going to attack with their Hinterland Drake now. Also, if they attack with Spontaneous Artist, I can just double block, so I'm pretty happy about that. Cogworker's Puzzle Knot. All right. Attack with this thing. I assume they're going to block it, in which case I get to bring it back. All right. Let's bring it back and draw a card. Good deal. Oh, Gearseeker Serpent. Can I play it all? Let's see if I do Puzzle Knot. One, two. Oh, wow. Look at this. Puzzle Knot. Foundry Assembler. Gearseeker Serpent. Look at that efficiency. Unbelievable. Did I draft a busted deck? I mean, Confiscation Coup certainly helps. Aethertide Whale. 6/4 flying, and you get a bunch of energy. They're just dead, right? I could actually make them sack creatures, but this is unblockable now. Now I just attack with everything and they die. All right. That was a sick game. A nice little fast one. Do I want a bounce spell? A minus one didn't look great. Bounce tap creature. Windrake. None of those sound great. Kind of like where we're at. All right. I mean, that whale's going to be pretty good against me, but it's kind of expensive, so hopefully I get curve out before that. Oh, look at this. Turn two Servo Schematic, turn three Foundry Assembler. This was really good last game. Both times I cast it, it was nice and efficient. And if I draw, ooh, well, if I draw Fatal Push, I'm happy because it's Fatal Push. But if I draw another cheap artifact, I might even be able to have a great turn. All right, well, look at that. Fatal Push that. Oh, interesting. So if I attack with Poisoner, I'll have one token. Play this. So it's not quite enough. Let's go Servo Schematic, because there's a chance if I draw another Cogworker's Puzzle Knot or a one drop that I can play Foundry Assembler and the other thing. I did not, so I'll just play the Assembler, and then next turn I'll go Puzzle Knot plus Poisoner. And also they're stuck on two lands, so this game's going to be quite short. Oh, all right. Well, let's just play the Barricade Breaker then. And then I expect a concession on this turn. And we have sped around round one. Let's get in the queue. I'll take it. Oh, I need to adjust my portrait a little. All right. There we go. Much better. All right. That was decent. Just the whole point with the improvised cards is getting to go two drop into curving those things in a way that really works out for you. All right, I'm on the play. Keep this hand, another land heavy hand, but Implement of Malice is a 2-for-1. Fatal Push obviously is great, and then Servo Schematic is very good for the deck. So let's see what they do. I'm going to lead on Swamp, of course, and hope that that is good. Barring any other information, I'm probably going to play Servo Schematic turn two, because not only does it put two artifacts into play, it can also just attack for one on the next turn. So clearly that's where I want to be. Okay. Ooh, Foundry Assembler. Yes. Yes, please. And next turn, again, if I draw Cogworker's Puzzle Knot, anything that puts two artifacts into play for two mana or one mana artifact into play is neutral on Foundry Assembler, so I'd play that, but this works too. Okay, Hungry Flames deals three to any target and two to me. Okay, yeah, let's play the Dragster. I can't crew it right now, but if I draw any creature, I can crew it, and I want this in play, ready to attack, rather than playing this, even though it's slightly mana inefficient. What does this do? Get two energy when it attacks, you can pay one to make another creature indestructible. Okay. Oh. So I can crew it. All right. Let's go. Well, I can crew it. I don't really care about getting attacked by this once, so let's go Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot. Draw land. So I guess it would have worked out to do it the other way, because if I had played Implement and sacked Implement, I could Fatal Push the Shield Guard, but then I wouldn't be able to attack with the Dragster. But this works fine. I used all my mana. Totally reasonable. The next turn I can use this plus Fatal Push, because this will get me Revolt. Probably kill the Shield Guard, but if they play a better creature I can kill, then I'll do that too. 5 mana, 4/4 flying. Or 3/3 flying, because it's just, but it pumps their team vigilance. Well, let's make you discard a card. I draw a card. I'm about to draw two more cards also. Okay, let's crew this. What'd they discard? Spark of Creativity. Oh, weird. Attack, and now if they double block, then I get to completely blow them out. But if they don't double block, I get to draw two cards. Oh, this is gonna be filthy. Kill the shield guard. Kill that. And then it dies anyway, and I draw two cards. Unbelievably good. I guess I have a one drop in deck now. All right, I drew a lot of land actually, but that was Fatal Push and Daredevil is two for two, and I drew two cards. So, pretty sick deal. Okay, play an artifact creature. Oh no, they're blowing up my thing. They have a 2/2 flying, and I have the Perilous Predicament. Well, I basically got an Ancestral Recall off, and I'm still losing. I guess I'll just pass, and hopefully they play an artifact creature. I'll probably take a hit for two here. And then if they play a weaker creature, I'll cast Perilous Predicament in response. Hopefully they play an artifact creature. No, they played another one. All right. I just do this. They sack the tapped one. It's fine. Okay. Spell? Oh, nice. Actually, let's get back the one drop and draw a card. Play the one drop. Play a land, because the one drop is actually going to be a lot bigger than play this, leaving mana up to pump the Augmenting Automaton once, which is now like a 5/5. Okay. This seems fine. Also, they're on, five lands, all spells, and I'm on 10 lands. So I might have gotten a 2-for-1, but they got like a 5-for-1 by drawing all those extra things. This is, of course, a problem. Flying Vigilance, lifelink, all your creatures get +1/+1. All right. Confiscation coup time. Island time. I'm at 7. I'm taking 5 in the air. Attack with this thing, I guess. Pump, 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 pump. All right. The good news is I'm not going to miss a land drop up to turn 12. I'm pretty dead here. I need basically to draw Confiscation Coup this turn, or I'm dead because I'm at 2 facing down 2 lethal flyers. Improvised Menace. Sure. All right. Oh, that was unfortunate. Perilous Predicament looks kind of bad. They don't really have very many artifacts, so I don't really want to play that. Scry one, implement. Shipwreck Moray. I might put in Metallic Rebuke. Their deck looked a little slow, like they had a bunch of decent 5-mana plays, so I think that works out well for me. That's not going to be very good. I could also put an Ironclad Revolutionary just because it's pretty big. What do I want to take out? I really don't think I want to take out any of the cheap artifacts. They kind of make this deck work. And I have two big things plus Baral's expertise and confiscation coup. Yeah, no, I think I'm okay with this. Okay, I would like to play first. Okay, I'll keep this hand. We've got turn two puzzle knot, turn three dragster, turn four puzzle knot. Hopefully draw some improvised cards or Gearseeker Serpents. 2 mana to tap an artifact or a creature. Sure. That's not a big deal. In the late game, this card can be pretty good. I mean, tapping down something is strong, but in the early game, it's not particularly. Dragster, hit for one. And this is a 2/3 flying vehicle with crew one. So they've played some cards that like need other resources to do something, which is not bad. Are they just going to leave their mana up to tap down the dragster? Okay, I'm fine with that. Oh, Gearseeker Serpent. Look at this. This is perfect. Okay. See if they let me attack. Obviously, if they tap my 1/1, I'll attack with the dragster. Otherwise, I'll just attack with the dragster. Oh. Destroy target artifact or enchantment. Sure. That's fine. I mean, turn four Gearseeker is sick, and then turn five Self-Assembler is not bad. Play a 2/2 flyer? Sure. Okay. No point in attacking with the 1/1s. Send for five here. Gearseeker. I would have loved a second Gearseeker. Gearseeker really makes this deck pop. All right. Land. Let's do some assembling. Okay, and let's get Foundry Assembler and then play it. Look at that assembling. 5 mana for a 4/4 plus a 3/3. Basically a Broodmate Dragon, but better because it's only 5 mana. So they did miss one land drop in this interim. Now they played a land, so they have four spells. But like look at Pacification. Pacification Array is not doing much work here. In order for them to use it, they basically have to not cast spells. And they're not definitely not in a position to not do that against a 4/4 and a 3/3. If they have some cheap removal, that's a different story. But even something like Fragmentize can't kill either of these because they cost five, which I do like that. I can't say I mind. Okay, they played the 3/4. Sure. The Serpent's a 5/6, so they can't even kill the Serpent. I can't attack with the 3/3, but I guess I can attack with the 4/4. And they're at 13. I could, what happens if I attack with everything? This eats that, this blocks that, and they take 10 down to 3. That actually seems fine to me. Because if I attack with the self-assembler, then they can double block the self-assembler and I just kill one thing. So, yep. Now they're basically in a spot where they have to tap down the serpent every single turn of the game. And I think that's going to put them in a pretty tough spot because next turn, if they can play something else, which they drew another land, so that's unfortunate, but they can't tap out because this can become unblockable. Let's hopefully they're not in a position to kill it. Improvised Menace, 3/3. Okay. So they're not going to attack here. Implement of Malice. All right, let's play this. Make you discard. See if I can draw something relevant. Okay, that's going to be pretty good. I don't think there's a reason not to play my land. I might just steal the Pacification Array. We'll see. They discarded a deal 4 damage to target creature card. Okay, but I guess it's expensive enough that it can't do much else. Let's see. Do I attack with the Self-Assembler? No, I don't think so. It just ends up trading for they double walk the 2-2 and a 3-3, and I kill the 3-3. It doesn't really seem like a fantastic deal. Six mana to make it unblockable, yeah. Brazen Scourge, 3-3 haste for 3. Okay. Ooh, do I have... Well, if I Confiscation Coup the Scourge, despite it having haste, they will just crew the Sky Skiff. Let's see. Oh, and a Fatal Push 2. So if I take the Scourge, they crew the Skiff, they tap the Serpent. I can attack with these. They double block and go to 1. Alternately, I just take the Pacification Array. Let's go to attacks. Okay. No attacks. Take the Pacification Array. And then now they have to have something that kills us 5-6 unblockable. And even if they do, Pacification Array is going to be really good for me when I'm pressuring them when they're at 3. All right. Game Triss. Bounce, no. Still didn't really see a reason to bring in Perilous Predicament. Though I actually kind of do want this Ironclad Revolutionary. It's really big. All right, I guess I have to take out... I just have to take out one of the artifacts here. Or... I have a bunch of Metal Spinners Puzzle Knots. Unless... All right, I'm going to draw Ironclad Revolutionary instead of an island. It is going to make me mulligan my hand, but nope. All right, I'll keep this hand. Any of my 2-mana artifacts that produce a cog worker, so like I have 4 2-mana artifacts that make me cast one of these on turn 3, and I also have a ton more artifacts that make me cast it turn 4. Also, they mulliganed. And I have Confiscation Coup, which is one of the best cards in my deck. Maybe just the actual literal best card in my deck. All right, I drew a 2-drop. It's really good. Island, less good. I'm glad I took out an island for a 6-drop in this with this hand. All right. Let's hope they don't kill it. End of turn. They did not. Hope they don't play a 2-2 flyer. They're probably going to. Yeah, that's fine. All right. Artifact. No, but there's a chance that... We'll see. Okay. Hopefully they decide to attack with the Osprey here because they're getting aggressive. Yeah, do it. It's not a big deal if I make an artifact. All right. Oh my god. This is just so awkward. All right. I'm just going to do it. It's that or just waste my mana my entire turn. I don't think that's a good play. I think I'd rather just play a Foundry Assembler. I downgrade my 1-2 into a 1-1. It wasn't doing anything otherwise. It was keeping their 2-2 back, I suppose. All right. So they're going to make some tokens. I am going to get to steal the Angel of Invention, though. So that's good. I do take 7 here. All right. Wow, I just drawn... Haven't really gotten there. Wait, no. I get 4 energy. I don't get to steal Angel Invention. Close one. I guess I steal this thing. And pass the turn and lose to Angel of Invention. All right, Angel of Invention is just an unbeatable card. It's a mythic rare Baneslayer that gives you everything you could possibly want. The funny thing is, had I drawn any artifact, I would have had an energy off that to steal it with Confiscation Coup. Not saying that would have necessarily won me the game, but certainly not going to win the game now. Oh, and Fragmentize, they just have it all. Yeah, all right. I am dead. All right, well, I was beating. I think my deck's good. Their deck was good, too. I mean, they didn't... They played a couple clunky cards, but the Angel really makes any deck great. And I did keep a slow hand game 3. I don't know if a faster hand would have won. The main thing I could have done differently game 3 was not attack with the Aether Swooper and just wait a turn and do nothing, or just play the 2-3 for 4, which is such a waste too. If I did that, then I'd be able to Confiscation coup the Angel, though I don't also know that that would have won me the game. Who knows? Okay, I'll keep this hand. This hand's pretty good, I would say. Okay, don't know what they're trying to do. All right, so turn 2, I'm just going to play the Swooper. Turn 3, the Dragster. And maybe turn 4, the Foundry Assembler. We'll see. 2-2, Revolt, make a 1-1. Well, black-white should have some good artifacts to sack with Perilous Predicament at least. Okay, I'll take 2. And what do they got? Oh, that one's good too. Ooh, Brawl's Expertise. I don't mind that. Just play the Dragster, attack, and make a token. Let's see. So next turn, if I don't care about attacking with Dragster, I can play Puzzle Knot and Assembler. I do want to attack with Dragster pretty badly, so I'll probably just play Assembler off the Servo token and then crew it with that. Let's see what they got. Alley Evasion, return a creature you control. So they're basically just playing that as a 1-1. Sure. All right, let's just go Foundry Inspector. Crew, and then I'll leave back the Swooper. Swoop, there it is. Because it keeps their 1-1 back. It's basically just trading 1 for 1 damage, which I don't think is great. I don't mind being a little aggressive here because I've got next turn I can play Brawl's Expertise or Perilous Predicament. They're both pretty good. And they're hitting me to 10. It's not like they're hitting me down to 5 or something like that. And then they have 3 cards in hand. They didn't play anything interesting. Actually, I think I'm just going to crew this like that. And then see what they do. Destroy target creature, gain life. Okay. That answers that question. Let's attack for 1. So I have a good play here, I think. Because then I can go Brawl's Expertise, these 3. And then put a Quicksmith Spy into play. And then target the Servo token and then just draw a card off Servo. Now they have to kill the Quicksmith Spy or the Servo, or they're losing really badly because I just have a tap draw card. Okay, they killed the Spy. I do have a way to get back Spy if I draw it. But also, they used their whole turn. It was 4 mana, destroy target creature or vehicle. Take 1. Another Puzzle Knot. In that case, I guess I'll just play the Automaton here. Attack for 5. And then end of turn, I'll sack the Puzzle Knot. It's more efficient to sack the Puzzle Knot than to cast a new one, mana-wise. And I don't care about losing an artifact for Improvise. I'm not really in a big bad spot for that. Salvager, and then they have a 2-2 they can play. Oh, they're playing Implement, so they're going to... They could sack it now to draw a card. Yeah, that's a good play, because now if they draw a land, they can play the 2-2 and they get a 1-1 token. Okay, let's go to 8, draw a card. Now, I guess I just cast Perilous Predicament, probably. Yeah, that seems pretty good. So let's just play the Puzzle Knot first, see if we draw something better to play. We don't. So now they're going to sack the 2-2 and the 1-1. And then I get to attack for 4, putting them to 6 here. Let's hope they don't have too much more. Hidden Stockpile, that card was pretty good. Basically as Revolt, so if something has left during your turn, you get a 1-1 and you can sack a creature to scry. Well, okay, So now they made a 4-4 and they're going to get a 1-1 end of turn. Do they attack for 4? I don't know that attacking for 4 is a good idea because they don't die if they do that, but they take a lot of damage. All right, so this augmenting automaton is now a 5-5. Okay. I'll send with these two then. The one drop that could. Now they have to double block to kill it. All right. It does use my whole turn, and I hope they don't have a trick. Because this they can only pump as a sorcery with its ability. Okay, they don't have anything, so now they go to 5. They're at 2 cards in hand. They're probably not getting stockpile value this turn. We'll see though. 2-1 flying, plus and plus so if you have an artifact. Okay. You're gonna sack it to scry one and get a 1-1. Okay. Oh, well, that's probably game. Play this. Oh, then they just scooped it up. Okay. Gonna get a nice little 2-1 here. Hopefully. Can black-white revolt. I do think Perilous Predicament's probably still fine here. Bouncing a creature. Fourth Bridge Prowler. I'm thinking of whether I want the bounce spell against their Defiant Salvager. I have Fatal Push and Brawl's Expertise and Confiscation Coup. That's probably enough. I think I want to stay pretty fast here. Okay, on the draw. Wait, they put me on the play. I'm gonna keep any hand with Confiscation Coup. I don't know that I would keep six lands Confiscation Coup, but I don't know why they put me on the play. That's a little weird. I think this format's pretty fast. Also, Foundry Assembler is really good if I draw any of the cheap artifacts, and well, that's means I'm gonna get it turn four at least. Ooh, they have a good start here. I'm probably gonna just wait. I can't crack the puzzle knot because I need to play Assembler on turn four. Okay. And then they're gonna sack this to gain two life and make a 1-1. Sure. All right, let's go Foundry Assembler. So we're gonna sack it to scry. This is gonna get a counter. I'm probably just gonna steal the Ninth Bridge Patrol at some point here. That sounds like a pretty good deal, though. I guess it's hard to steal things in the face of Hidden Stockpile. Wow, now their deck's actually doing their thing. So yeah, sure. They have the one white combat trick. That's fine. Or they're gonna sack a 1-1 to make this into a 3-3. No, they plus one plus two. That's fine. That's fine. Ooh, Quicksmith Spy. Okay, let's just start valuing here. Let's draw a card. I didn't draw the one drop. So now I'm going to take a little bit of damage this turn, but not even that much because obviously, if they kill the spy, they kill the spy. They have a bunch of removal spells. They might just kill it. But if they don't, somehow. Yeah, they did. They don't get revolt this turn. They do attack me for 6. Oh, Fatal Push is nice. Actually, I'm at 13. I can go even more value. Let's play this, draw a card. Oh yeah, the Brawl's Expertise makes this even better. No reason to draw right now because I've already played my land. I don't have any zeros. And next turn. So they're gonna pump the Ninth Bridge Patrol a bunch. But I'm setting up to either kill it or bounce it or steal it, depending on what they do. I feel like this is gonna be decent. If they can't kill the 2-3, then this thing can't attack past my spy. Whoa, what is going on here? Okay, you've got a 6-6 or 5-5. Why are we? I guess I don't get why we sacked all of it. Okay. Draw a card. All right. They have a 5/5. They're tapped out. Yeah, let's steal the 5/5. Yeah, pay the 2. Play a 1/1 death touch. Maybe just pass the turn. I also am probably going to Brawl's Expertise the Quicksmith Spy and then replay it. Okay. Boom. And that'll do it. We got a nice 2-1. Oh, this is a cube deck. I like that deck too. hold on. Where did my deck go? I want to look at it again. All right. Yeah, this deck was good. I like the improvised stuff. Could have used another Gear Seeker. Lost Angel Invention twice. Totally happy with that. And that was our Flashback Kaladesh draft. Thanks for watching and hanging out as I got to play one of a sweet older format. And yeah, you can expect a little bit of most Flashback formats. If there's one you particularly like, let me know in the comments. I love to hear your feedback. And as always, keep on drafting. I'll see you tomorrow with another awesome video. Or the best I can do, at least. I'll see you then.